Hi, I'm Lauren from the Twifties Show, and we're here at Houlihan Lawrence in Katonah with our friend Karen Benvin Ransom. Let's see what she's got going on. Hi, Karen.
Hi, Lauren. How are you today?
Good. I'm glad we could be here, and you're going to tell us about Katonah and also about the many interesting things that you're involved in.
Oh, thank you so much. First of all, welcome to Katonah. This is how I usually start with my clients as we sit in this room. And I'll tell them the history of Katonah. It was moved in 1897 to this site from a site just northwest of here in order for New York City to be able to create the reservoir system. And they also asked the Frederick Law Olmsted firm of Massachusetts to design this new town, which they did with plenty of green space. And 85 buildings from the old Katonah were moved into the new sites.
So it was really a very well-planned town as opposed to sprouting up willy-nilly.
Perhaps one of the earliest.
Okay. And what else?
What else? Well, it's a great walking tour. There's one out by the Katonah Village Improvement Society. You can take the guide with you and go house by house. There's even a very fascinating building behind the Blue Dolphin, which used to be a movie theater. I had no idea Katonah once had a movie theater. But then it went out of business when Mount Kisco, which is always the big town in this area, brought in the talkies years ago.
Many years ago. Yes. Now, as well as Katonah's interesting history, you have an interesting history, don't you?
Thank you.
And you're one of the founders of Homeris, which, of course, most people in this area know. Tell us about founding that and tell us what's happening with it now.
Well, we started it in the backyard in 1976 using a little cheap smoker from the L.L. Bean Company.
Just describe what Homeris is or was.
Well, it was a smokehouse.
Okay.
And we started with smoked trout, smoked it in the backyard in Purchase, New York for 3 years until we bought our building in Mount Kisco on Kisco Avenue. And we had a very popular Saturday sale that people from this area enjoyed every Saturday from 10 till 3. And they came there every Saturday very loyally, and I used to have coupons that they all loved. And they used to see all the excitement behind the scenes. They were shipping to the White House, or shipping to the Academy Awards, or supplying Air France, or the Concorde flights.
Wow.
It was quite a ride.
Wow. And how long did you have that business?
Over 20 years.
Okay. And now you've been a broker here for 9 years?
Yes.
Okay. And you live on Museum Mile in Katonah.
Yes, I do.
That's the first time I've ever heard that phrase. Yeah. Where is that? And tell us about what's on it.
Museum Mile is part of Route 22, which starts with the Katonah Museum of Art, continues on south to the John Jay Homestead, and also it's a historic site as well, and they give tours as well as there. And then if you continue south, you get to Caramore, which is beyond, there's the music festival, but there's also the Rosenhaus Museum, where I'm a docent. I'm also a docent for the shows at the Katonah Museum of Art.
You're tied in everywhere. Now, a docent is a guide.
It's a teacher, someone that will help everyone understand an artist, a time period, and the show they're enjoying.
And you're an art history major, so it comes naturally to you, of course.
Well, you know, after all these years, I feel as though my parents are looking down from heaven that finally she's using her art history background.
It's wonderful at this age, at this time in our lives, being Twifties, that we can finally use all the things that we've been gathering
up
and
not?
Studying.
If not now, when?
Exactly.
You've got to do it now.
And Karen, you're very athletic. I know that you go to Curves in Pound Ridge because that's how we met.
Mm-hmm.
And you're a dancer, and you're going to take up dancing, ballet again.
Once again.
Yes.
I used to have a full dance studio in my condo in Guard Hill Manor in Mount Kisco.
Oh, so you were quite serious.
I was quite serious many years ago, but I look forward to getting back to ballet. I think ballet has the most wonderful exercises at the ballet bar.
I agree. Well, I have a fun little toy I just want to show you. Maybe we'll try this out together. This is called the burn machine, and let's open it up and take a look. This is its carrying case, and Karen, why don't you go ahead and pick it up? This is the first time you've ever seen this, right?
Oh my goodness, I've never, looks like handcuffs.
Pick it up, and you can lift it, you can use it as weight like that, lift it over your head.
I don't want to hit anything here. Looks like my Bende dots on my skirt.
Yes, and you can put it behind your head. And
I've got a watch doing that because I had a broken shoulder from a car accident years ago.
Okay, and let me show you some other things.
Okay.
All right, so this is the 8-pound model of the burn machine. It's called the speed bag, and you can see that you can use it like a punching bag, and my arms muscles are starting to burn. I can feel it. So I just leave this around my house and pick it up now and then and give it a shot. You can do a lot of different exercises. You can go like this. You can use it as a still weight, dead weight over the head. And there's a whole list of things you can do. So anyway, you might not have ever seen this before, and I just wanted to show it to you.
Great way to burn off some anticipation, anxiety, or whatever you have going on.
That's right. You could keep it right in the office.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Karen.
Okay, bye.
Karen?
Yes?
Where can people find out more about what you do online?
Well, I've got a great website. It's very easy to remember. It's www.karenfromkatonah.com.
That's a cute name. How'd you come up with that?
Well, easy. I used to be Karen from Homeris for many years, and then I just had to answer the phone with a new ending, so I just became Karen from Katonah, Julianne Lawrence, and I love alliteration. I named my son Ross Ransom with the RR. So it's KarenFromKatonah.com.
Alliteration is great. Being a professional namer, I agree. Now, your blog site, is that on there too? Or
my blog site is, yes, there's a link to my blog site on the homepage of my website where you see many, many photographs of Katonah, Bedford, Pound Ridge, North Salem, the whole surrounding area.
And you know, I can tell by reading your blog, you love Katonah, you love to write, and you're so pleased to share what you know. So I've enjoyed the blog, and I think others will too.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.